goes
on. Mother Teresa is an individual who stands out today as one of the heroes of today. She doesn't stand for a life that's, you know, whatever you feel and, you know, whatever your emotions tell you, follow that. She tells the truth, and that her life represents a life of suffering, accepting suffering and offering it to God, which is what the Catholic life is all about.
She's serving the sick and the dying, and it's very important that people go out and help others.
My grandmother and my aunts and my cousins and my friend are here because no matter how old you are, young or old, everyone can come to enjoy Mother Teresa speaking. Everyone can share her affection.
She looks at each individual as another Christ, and I think this is very edifying for all of us to imitate, and I love and respect her very much.
Because I feel that Sister Teresa is a walking saint. And I feel if I'm in this group, that I will come closer to God. And I think by praying for peace is very important. And she's from Yugoslavia, where I was born.
Because she serves people that are dying all around the world.
I'm here because I want to hear what Mother Teresa has to say and to pray the rosary. My children are here, and they have never had the opportunity to really see someone, I think, that's as blessed as she is and is giving. And I hope that her attitude will impart onto them what life is all about, which is sharing and caring and showing love to people.
How often do we get the opportunity to see and to hear a living saint? For most of us today, the answer is never. But for 10,000 people in Long Beach, California, their opportunity was to attend a second annual Rosary for Peace rally, featuring an address by Mother Teresa of Calcutta. Even before she received the Nobel Peace Prize, Mother Teresa was known to Catholics all over the world as someone who truly lives Christ's message, to love one another. Her work with the poorest of the poor serves as a model of Christian charity, and the vitality of her order is testimony to her charisma as a Catholic leader. Welcome to Heart of the Nation, a window on the Catholic world. I'm Father Liam Kidney, and with me is Barbara Valentine.
Thank you, Father. There was a great deal of excitement and anticipation at Veterans Memorial Stadium.
So now let's return to June 16th, 1986, and the Rosary for Peace rally.
I'd be introduced, Mother Teresa of Calcutta. Welcome, please.
As we have gathered together to show our love for Mary, the mother of Jesus and our mother, let us say the prayer together. Mary, mother of Jesus, give us your heart so beautiful, so pure, so immaculate, your heart so full of love and humility, that we may be able to receive Jesus in the bread of life, love him as you loved him, and serve him in the distressing disguise of the poor. We read in the Gospel that God loved the world so much that he gave Jesus to Mary. An angel came to give her the news. And the news was that she had been chosen, that she was full of grace, that she was pleasing to God, and that he had chosen her for something very, very special. And Mary understood very little, but she understood that she, who had consecrated her virginity to be virgin, her chastity to be chaste, her purity to be pure, couldn't understand. And then we know the angel told her that she would become the mother of Jesus, that the Holy Spirit will come to her, and she will conceive. And she said that wonderful, wonderful offer. So beautiful, humble. Though she knew that she was going to be now the mother of God. Behold, the handmaid of the Lord. And we say that he called that beautiful action between God and Mary the Annunciation, the announcing of coming of Christ. It was her first Holy Communion day. And she prayed, and she kept everything in her heart. And so we together now, we will say the Hail Mary together with the angel, that we too realize the fullness of gift of God through Mary to us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the coming of Christ in her filled her with the tender love of Jesus. with the tender love of God himself. And she went in haste. To do what? Just to be a handmaid. To clean, to wash, to cook, to take care of her cousin, Elizabeth, who was already with a child for 6 months. And she came there to prove that he had come without saying anything, that he had come and that with haste she was anxious to go as soon as possible and give his love, his presence to her cousin. And something very, very strange happened when she came there. The little one, the little unborn child in the womb of his mother Elizabeth, leaped with joy at the presence of Christ. How strange that God should use an unborn child to proclaim the coming of Christ. And there we understand today the terrible happenings to that little unborn child. We know how Mary received Jesus, and we know today how terribly mother herself kills her own child, murders her own child. What a terrible, terrible sin of murder. Greater still because it is its own mother. And we read in the scripture where God says, even if mother could forget her child, I will not forget you. I have carved you on the palm of my hand. You are precious to me. I love you. That little unborn child is created in the image of God, is created for greater things, to love and to be loved. And today, abortion has become the greatest destroyer of peace because it destroys the presence of God, God's tender love for the family, for the life that he gives. Let us for a second pray to Our Lady for our parents who have wanted us, who have loved us, who have not aborted us because they wanted us. Today, millions of little unborn child are destroyed, are thrown away. You who have all gathered here today to proclaim the love and tenderness for Mary and gratitude to Mary for accepting to be a mother to Jesus. Let us pray. Let us pray to her that we may help the mothers who want to destroy their child, that we may have the courage to help them, to prevent them from killing that little unborn child created in the image of God. Mary, Mother of Jesus, be mother to those little ones, the little unborn children, who in thousands and thousands are being destroyed by their own mother. Just as love begins at home, evil has begun at home. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Joseph and Mary had to go to Bethlehem, and it was the time for Mary to give birth to the little one in her womb. It was the time when Jesus, the Son of God, having become poor like us, to be born in a stable. And they went to Bethlehem in obedience to the king, to Caesar, who want to show his greatness by having everyone go to their own country to sign, to write their names. Mary could have easily stayed back, and Joseph could have stayed with her. But that tender obedience, that obedience to the will of God that came to them through the king was sufficient for them. Is our obedience to the church so delicate? Do we really obey and live that obedience in our families, in our homes, in our own lives? Today, that obedience to the church, that obedience to the Holy Father, how often is disregarded, thrown away? Let us today, while here we are with Mary, let us promise that we will be true children of God, true children of the church, we will obey and see Mary and Joseph looking everywhere. They were so poor that they had nowhere to go but somewhere outside the town to look for a place. And there was Jesus born. So beautiful, so pure, so holy, yet there was nothing but a stable. There was nothing but a manger. There was nothing but straw to keep him warm. And I think there was the little donkey with its breathing helping to keep Jesus warm. What poverty. He chose to be poor like us, so that we will learn to accept suffering, to accept poverty with his help. In our lives too, suffering will have to come. These privations will have to come. Let us not forget that Jesus and Mary and Joseph went through it before. And let us have deep love for the poor, for the hungry, for the naked, for the homeless. That is why when Jesus grew up, again and again, he had a deep love for the poor. And to make it easy for us to love the poor, and to make it easy for the poor, that we take the trouble to take care of them, to help them. He said, whatever you do to the least of my brethren, you do it to me. If you receive a little child in my name, you receive me. If you give a glass of water in my name, you give it to me. And again, he tried to make us understand the tender love of God, to give us the opportunity to love him. Because how can we love God whom we don't see? St. John says, how can you say that you love God whom you don't see if you do not love your neighbor whom you see? This is make this difficulty to remove from us. Jesus, even at the hour of our death, when we go home to God, because death is nothing but going home to God. Even then, Jesus said, I was hungry and you gave me to eat. Hungry not only for bread, hungry for love, for the word of God, for the tender concern of somebody. Naked, I was naked, and you clothed me. Not only with a piece of cloth. Nakedness is that loss of that beautiful human dignity of the child of God. The dignity that have been created to love and to be loved. The dignity of that beautiful virtue, purity. That we keep our purity pure. That we keep our chastity chaste. That we keep our virginity virgin. This is a nakedness, and that is lost. I was homeless, and you took me in. Not only for a house made of bricks, but was homeless, unwanted, unloved, a throwaway of society. But today we have right here in our country. We see the poor people. We see the young people with that disease, unwanted, unloved, a throwaway of society. Are we there to be that love, that kindness, that thoughtfulness to them, and share with them the terrible pain, the terrible feeling of terrible loneliness, being a throwaway, have no one to be somebody to somebody. This is the nativity of Jesus, being poor, being born as a poor. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. We see Joseph and Mary going to the temple. Again, an act of obedience. It was not necessary for Mary to be purified, for she was a virgin before the birth. She was virgin at birth, and she was virgin after the birth. And yet, to obey the law, they went and presented the child in the temple, taking just two little doves as offering. Imagine how poor they were. They could not bring a lamb. They had to bring two little doves in exchange for the special blessing that the presentation would give. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. When the child grew, they went to the temple, and after, you can imagine the three of them praying with so much love, with so much fervor, because love begins at home, and the three of them were the home. They loved each other. They prayed together. They stayed together. And because they stayed together, they loved each other so tenderly. We too, and for us too, love begins at home. And how does it begin? By praying together. For family that prays together, stays together. And if we stay together, we will love one another as God loves each one of us. So let us remember, love begins at home. And so the three of them, and coming away, the little one stayed back. And you could imagine Mary's worry, anxiety. And the two of them walking, looking. Do we look for our child? Do we miss the little one? Do we give that tender love to our little one? Or we have no time? I never forget one night, late at night, midnight, I heard the bell in our house. And I went down, and there was a little child crying. And I asked, why, what has happened? And he said, I went to my father. My father didn't want me. I went to my mother. My mother did not want me, but I know you want me. I came to you. Does your child feel unwanted, unloved? Love begins at home. See that in your family, never, no man, no woman, no child, no unborn child feels unwanted. Do not be afraid to love as God loves you, with a tender love, with a concern, with a worry, where is my child? Like Mary and Joseph walked back. They looked for him for 3 days. They did not rest until they found the child. Do we feel like that? My husband, my wife, my child, where, how, worried, sick, lonely, am I the joy to him or to her? What is my concern? Maybe just a smile. Maybe just a little flower to bring. Maybe just a little shake of hand. I never forget one day I was walking down the street in London. And I saw the man sitting, crushed up simply, looking so miserable, with his red head right down. And I went near to him. I took his hand. I shook his hand. And I asked him how he was. And my hand is always very warm. And the man sat up. And he said, oh, after a long, long, long time, I feel the warmth of a human hand. And his eyes brightened up. He sat up. He was like a different being. He felt, somebody loves me. So somebody cares for me. And another beautiful example of a small thing that you and I can do continually in our own family first. And we went to Australia, and the sisters and I, we went to the reserve to meet the people there living in those little houses. And then I went to one room, and I saw very dirty and smelling and all that. So I said to him, kindly allow me to clean your room and wash your clothes. And the man said, I'm all right. But I said, no, you'll be more all right if you allow me to clean. And then he allowed me. Then in cleaning the place after finished, I saw in the corner of the room a beautiful big lamp covered with dirt. And I asked him, do you light this lamp at night? And he said, for whom? For years, nobody has come to see me at that time. And then I asked him, will you light the lamp if the sisters come to see you? He said, yes. Then the sisters started going, and every evening the light was burning, and they came. I forgot all about him. After 2 years, he sent me word, tell my friend the light she has lit in my life is still burning. This is finding Jesus. You can imagine Our Lady telling Jesus, why did you do like that? See, Father and I have been looking for you. And he said, did you not know? That had to be my Father's business. But anyway, Our Lady must have taken his hand and taken him back home. And we read in the Gospel something very beautiful. He was subject to them. That like little child, the Son of God, obeying Joseph, obeying Mother Mary for 30 years. This is something that we must bring in our family, that oneness, that joy of being together, that love that produces more love, that compassion, that understanding. And this is what you and I will be able to receive if we learn this concern, this compassion for our family, for our neighbor, that tender concern. One day a man came to our house and he said, there is a family with 8 children, have not eaten for such a long, long time. They will all die if we don't do anything. So I took rice with me and I went. And when I came to the family, I could see the terrible hunger, the terrible pain of hunger in the faces of the children. But the mother took the rice from my hands. And instead of going to the kitchen, she went out. She came back with half of the amount. And I asked her, where did you go? What did you do? And she said, they are hungry also. Next door neighbor, she knew they were hungry. I was not surprised that she gave, but I was surprised that she knew. Because when we suffer, we forget that somebody else is suffering. This is tenderness. This is concern. This is what Jesus came to teach us. And where will we learn that? When we look at the cross, we know how much he loved us. He loved us so tenderly that there at the cross, he gave us his mother. Be mother to us. Mary, mother of Jesus, be mother to us. For he, on his last deathbed, remembered us and gave us his mother to love her and to love her in loving all those little children, all the sick and the crippled and the mental and the old and the suffering. This is something so wonderful, the gift of God that comes to us through Mary. And so let us ask today that we have all gathered here to honor her, to love her, to show our deep, deep love for her. Let us promise her that we will make our little families another Nazareth, where love and compassion will come in if you all use this. She will always come to us if we are faithful to the Rosary. We, Our Lady, the Immaculate Heart of Mary, is in a special way the cause of our joy. We call her Immaculate Mother, Immaculate Heart of Mary, cause of our joy. Bless your own missionaries of charity. Help us to do all the good we can. Keep us in your Immaculate Heart so that we may cling to Jesus, as love Jesus as you love him. Serve him in the distress in disguise. Where do those young sisters? God has blessed us with many vocations, and I am very grateful to you all who have so generously given your children to be consecrated to God, to be the priests at the altar of God. For that is, I think, the greatest gift God can give to a family, to choose one of your children to belong to him only. To be the spouse of Jesus crucified, to be that priest at whose word the bread becomes Jesus, the wine becomes precious blood, at whose word, at whose absolution, a sinner full of sin becomes a sinner without sin. What a grace for the family. So let us pray to Mary. Let us ask her to pray for our family, to obtain for our family the grace that some one or two of our children be chosen to be consecrated to him, to be only all for him. And I will pray for you that you may grow in holiness through this love for Mary. Be only all for Jesus through Mary. Make your family one heart full of love in the heart of Jesus through Mary. And this has been, for the missionaries of charity, the greatest gift, the Mother of Jesus. And we pray the Rosary wherever we go, in the streets, in the buses, in anywhere. And naturally, Rosary is our family prayer at adoration, where we meet every day for 1 hour, we pray the Rosary. And I ask your parish priest to give you the beautiful gift of adoration. For Jesus made himself bread of life because he loves us so tenderly, and he wants us to love him as he loves each one of us. God has blessed us with many vocations, and I believe it is because we try to make our lives woven with the Eucharist through Mary. Mary, our mother and our queen. We give you our heart. We give you all that we have, all that we are, all that we can be. Keep all for Jesus, so that you and Jesus, when we meet with you, you will be able to recognize us as your own children, full of love, full of peace, full of joy, full of humility. Help us to become humble like you, that we may be holy like Jesus. Have a tender love for the poor. Right here in your own country, I don't know if you know, our sisters are in 16 places taking care of the poorest of the poor, of the unwanted, of the unloved, of the uncared. Last Christmas Eve, we opened a home for the AIDS. And I can't tell you what tremendous change God has made in their lives, because there is somebody who loves them, somebody who wants them. So let us pray for us, that we may not spoil God's work. I will pray for you, and also I will pray that God may choose some of your children in a special way to belong to Him only, to be consecrated to Him, to become the priest of God, the spouse of Jesus crucified. You parents, pray for them. And the young people, remember, to love a young girl is beautiful. And a young girl to love a young man is beautiful. But the greatest gift, the most beautiful gift that you can give each other on your day of marriage is a virgin heart, a virgin body, a pure heart, a pure body. And this Our Lady will obtain for you if you every day pray the three Hail Marys to her. She will protect your purity, and your purity will remain pure. Your chastity will remain chaste, and your virginity will remain virgin, because she will obtain the grace from you, for you, from her Son. Pray for us, as we will pray for you. God bless you.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
That Mother Teresa set foot here, I felt a very special presence of someone indeed very holy. It was a very moving, powerful experience for me today.
I just feel full of happiness inside.
I felt the presence of the Lord very much. Mother Teresa was wonderful. She has a feeling of godliness and leaves it wherever she goes.
She does make me cry.
I think it was wonderful, and a saint who visited us led us. It was absolutely wonderful.
She made me feel like very glad to be a Catholic and to be part of God's family.
It was a very moving experience. I thought it was wonderful. She impressed me so much. She's the dearest, tiniest, sweetest little thing I've ever seen.
I just saw it in the paper and I thought it'd come by, and it shook me up. She's dynamic.
Well, she makes me feel like I want to be a better person, that I want to do, you know, do things that I often think of doing but don't do, and being a kinder, better, more sympathetic person.
She's my dad's heroine, I mean. And so when he heard about this, you know, he got the whole family out here. And so we all came, you know, we all, you know, praying the rosary and everything.
She inspires me to be a better person, to try to be a holy person, and moves me very much.
Mother Teresa is such a great example of Christ and a living saint on this earth. It's just a wonderful thing.
Life goes on.